Alright, so today we're doing a Regigigas raid. This is actually my first EX Regigigas raid. The only other one that I have was from the Regigigas event. So these guys are super nice. I came up maybe like a minute after the hatch and everybody was already jumped into the raid, so these guys were super nice. They jumped out for me. Thank you guys.
I was actually one of the ones that didn't jump out.
Well, that's how it
but
is.
But I did I guess. See enough. You guys had enough, so I was like, okay, I'll just stay out.
Right. So what's your name?
Reese.
Reese?
Yeah.
Thank you for jumping out, Reese.
Oh, no worries.
And your name?
Nick.
Nick jumped out as well, so thank you. And of course, there's a couple other people that jumped out, but they don't want to be on camera, so that's super cool. But I just want to emphasize to you guys, like, if you see a player running up and they want to do the raid, please jump out for them. Unless it's going to take you, like, more than 5 minutes, I don't understand why people don't jump out. Like, I mean, I understand, like, if somebody calls and is like, hey, I'm 15 minutes away, can you wait? Like, no, don't wait for that person. But, like, if somebody just walked up and you're still in the lobby, why the hell would you not jump out of the raid for them?
Yeah,
it drives me
insane. Don't be this guy.
Don't be that guy. Don't be that guy. It happens all the time, and that's what's killing our community. That's why people are starting alternate accounts left and right, because they don't want to have to help other people, and it's very selfish. So think about that next time you guys see another raider running up to the raid group. Now, let's see if this is a 100%. All right, everyone, check out this graphic by Couple of Gaming. The 100% is 2483, and the 100% for Weather Boosted is going to be 3104. And the best counters are all fighting types. You've got Kunkeldurr, Lucario, Machamp, Breloom, Hariyama, and Toxicroak. So pretty good. I think most of us have those. Kunkeldurr is the only one that's brand new. So hopefully you guys have a good Lucario or Machamp by now. 2483, please, Regigigas. Oh, that's good though. 2473. So this is probably like a 86?
Probably higher than that.
Maybe 92? Let's capture it.
2483 is 100, right?
Yeah, 2483 is 100. So it's
at least in the 90s for sure.
Oh, snap.
93, I'll guess.
Let's see. Well, it's got a huge circle on it right on the crotch. Let's see if I can nail an excellent throw here. Boom! I got the excellent. Not so bad. Just lock it right to his crotch. Ugh, man. Okay, he's going to be a little tough, but we got 11 balls. Got it! Yeah! Okay, so now I can finally appraise it and see what this beast is. Perfect for my 4-day streak. Yes, let's see. Ooh, 15 attack, 15 defense, and what, 13 HP? That's honestly incredible. I'm so happy that I came out to this EX raid today. My best Regigigas, better than my other one that I got from the event. Okay, I just want to let you know that I made a whole clip ranting about how pissed off I am right now about lots of different stuff, and it took me about 30 minutes to say everything concisely. And I just want to let you know, if I don't put that clip in this video, that I'm pissed off right now. And I can't say how I actually feel about the things that I can't talk about, because I have this lovely YouTube platform where you guys only want to see happy, beautiful, rainbow, sunshine, and unicorns, and everything's happy, and I'm happy all the time. So let's get back to being happy, I guess. Ooh, it looks like today I'm going to get my research breakthrough box. So we need to use 5 berries to help capture Pokemon. That seems pretty easy. Let's grab this Illumise. All I need to do is throw a berry on it to get this done. So let's actually, well, yeah, whatever. I don't want to waste a golden Raz or something. So let's just great ball. By the way, Illumise is one of the Pokemon that's going to be featured at the Taiwan Lantern Festival Safari Zone. So if you're in the Asia Pacific region and you still need Illumise, maybe you'll get to go to the Taiwan Lantern Festival and check it out. We used 1 berry to help capture Pokemon. So let's do that 4 more times. Okay, this is actually awesome. Oh, no, I was so happy for like 3 seconds. I saw a wild Golett on the nearby. Let me walk back a little bit. Maybe it'll show up again. Dang, it's amazing how like happiness is so fleeting. Like, by the way, there's ducks everywhere out here. Did I seriously just loot? There it is. Wow. Golett right here. This is actually the very first wild Golett that I have seen ever. I have only ever, I think, hatched 1 Golett ever in my career. So this is pretty exciting. Super rare Pokemon. I do not have Golurk yet. By the way, there's a million ducks everywhere. Look at how cute they are. They're in a little goose line right here. Let's pineapp it and do another Ultra Ball. Go! Oh man, we almost got the excellent throw.
Wow, check this out. This Golett is the first one that I have. This is my Pokedex entry Golett. Really good stats, and this one is not bad. This is the wild one that I just caught, but I'm glad that I went to go back and check because this one is almost 100%. So I'm very happy to evolve this one into Golurk. Let's go ahead and do it. 50 candies to evolve Golett into Golurk. Let's send them up. There it is, Golurk, super cool. Oh my gosh, I love this Pokemon so much. Registered to the Pokedex, yay! I love Golurk, look at how cool he is. This makes me wanna play Sword and Shield, honestly, because he is just, look at this. I always do this. I always appraise things after I evolve it. They're gonna have the same stats. Let me know in the comment section below, do you do that too? Are you like me where you always appraise things twice? It's so, why do we do that? Why do we do that? Anyway, Golurk. Incredible, such a cool Pokemon, ground and ghost type, such an interesting typing, super cool. I actually do want to check out his Pokedex entry. Golurk is the automation Pokemon. When the seal on its chest is removed, it rages indiscriminately, turning the whole town around it into a mountain of rubble. Oh my god, just that little bandage is keeping that thing from destroying everything. Oh my goodness. Well, cool, very powerful, very cool Pokemon. Nice. But now, since we have completed our research task of pineapping 5 different Pokemon, now we can check if we get a shiny Lapras with Ice Shard and Ice Beam. What do you guys think? Here we go. Let's check. Research breakthrough box, 2,000 Stardust, 20 Pokeballs, and we get 3,000 XP. Let's see if we're going to get shiny Lapras. Not shiny, but at least it will have Ice Shard, Ice Beam. Let's capture this one. Nice, we caught Lapras with Ice Shard and Ice Beam out of the research breakthrough box. It's got pretty good stats, but still, I already have a lucky one and a shiny one, so we don't really need it, but maybe if you still need Lapras with Ice Shard, Ice Beam, you guys can grab that up. I've already checked that Tauros, let's check this Totodile, not shiny. And let's check this Treecko, no, let's keep hunting. Hey, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna open my mystery box because I have not done this in so long. And you know what? I want to get some Meltan candies because I'm going to work on trying to get a 100% Meltan. I still do not have a 100% Meltan. Here's our first Meltan. And just so you guys know, Meltan cannot be shiny right now. It's only possible to be shiny once Nintendo decides to do like an exclusive event for like Let's Go Pikachu or Let's Go Eevee or maybe for Sword and Shield or something like that. But they haven't done that in a long time. And they certainly haven't done anything since they've been focusing on Sword and Shield. So maybe in the future we'll have another shiny Meltan event. But anyway, you're just going to get regular Meltans out of the box. But this is your reminder right now that, look, Melmetal costs 400 candy to evolve. So if you still have not evolved your Meltan, please remember to do your Meltan box and get those candies cooking. So now that I've got this box on, let's walk around for 30 minutes and see what we find. Oh, hey, look, there's a Roggenrola here. That's so cool. New Gen 5 Pokemon. I still do not have Boldore or Gigalith, so I really hope that I can capture this one. 846 CP, he's a big boy. Let's capture him and appraise it, and maybe we can finally evolve it today. Oh wow, it was a really good thing I checked, because look at my inventory. I actually have a lucky Roggenrola. I forgot about this one. It was traded to me from Super Trainer Sakura. By the way, shout out to Super Trainer Sakura. She recently just hit 2,000 subscribers. That's what's up. Thank you guys for subscribing to her. Look at this one, really good stats. And I've got 121 candies right now, so let's go ahead and evolve this Roggenrola into Boldore. I mean, it's lucky, and we had the field research of evolve a Pokemon anyway. I think evolve a Pokemon is Eevee, so we should see if I get a shiny Eevee, but check it out right here. We got Boldore! Super cool. I actually had Gigalith teamed back in Gen 5. Look at that thing, Boldore. Super cool. I actually really love this family. I think it's super cool. Lucky. Oh, and look, oh my gosh, actually we can evolve it right now because I did already trade this one. So check it out, see the little check mark next to the trade symbol. And so it cost me 0 candy to evolve it. Yay, so Roggenrola, Gigalith, and Boldore are a family of Pokemon that benefit from the trade bonus. So you know what, let's go ahead and evolve it because it's 0 candy and it's lucky. Let's evolve Boldore into Gigalith, right on, send Boldore up. And there's Gigalith. How cool is this Pokemon? He looks so awesome. He lights up. I actually didn't know that he lights up. Oh, added to the Pokedex. Oh, yeah. Check it out. Lucky Gigalith. Thank you to Super Trainer Sakura. Guys, look at how cool this Pokemon is. Ah, I love him. He's so cool, and I love that it lights up. By the way, the shiny is insane. It looks so cool. Instead of red parts, he's got like a light blue kind of color. Oh, man. I can't wait till the shiny comes out. I'm so excited. 2006 CP, lucky Gigalith right there. Nice. Okay, And I'm still pulling these Meltans, only a minute left. We'll have to see which one is my best one. Check it out, guys. We found puppies. Hi, puppies. What's their names?
It's Mia.
Mia. Hi, Mia. She's so cute. And Tasha, what kind of dog are they?
They're called Morkies.
Morkies?
Yeah, it's kind of a hybrid. It's been around for 20 years. They're a Maltese Yorkie mix.
Maltese Yorkie mix. Well, obviously, dogs make everybody happy, right? Right on. Have a great day, guys.
Take care.
So, guys, we're walking around the park, and we found doggy friends. Hi. What's this one's name?
Nalu.
Nalu?
Nalu.
Nalu.
Yeah.
Oh, she's scared. Hiding between her owner's legs. And we got another pup over here. What's his name?
Bandit.
Bandit, and he's all happy. He's super cute, of course. Their owner doesn't want to be in the camera, but I just want to say, dogs make everything better, right?
Yes, definitely.
Yes, they do. Or cats, any animal, pets in general, make things better. Very nice. Have a great day.
You too.
Guys, we found Nick. He's another dog lover. Check it out. And who? What's her name?
Musa.
Musa is such a sweetheart. Look at this. Look at this. She probably, I have a cat. She probably
smells like. She smells everything.
She smells the cat. But anyway, more dogs making everybody's day. Thank you very much. Have a great day.
You too. Thank you.
Very cool. I just got so excited because finally a Timburr has appeared before me in the park just across the way. You guys can see it at the top of my map. I've got 24 minutes left. I'm hobbling my way over there. Let's go get this Timburr. All right, we made it to the Timburr raid. This is my first ever Timburr raid, and there's one other person in the lobby. I can see them standing across the park. Whee! Over there. By the way, I just want to bring up, this is kind of like another one of my pet peeves with Pokemon Go. If you come to a raid and you're alone and you see other people at the raid that are clearly playing Pokemon Go, try to make small talk with them. In fact, I'm gonna go try to talk to this guy. Let's see what happens. But first I'm gonna check to see, actually I'm gonna get him to check it. Let's see if he will. Guys, so this is Everett. He's super cool. Say hi.
Hi, how are you doing?
Guys, he was just telling me that he's on his way to defeat Giovanni, right?
Yes, yes.
He's putting his team together. He's got his Lucario. He's gonna power it up.
And we're gonna hopefully take him over and get it going, and we'll be in good shape.
Yeah.
And get the next research going.
Yeah, and you gotta get Shadow Moltres before February.
Okay,
so
okay.
So make sure you guys finish up Giovanni before February 1st. Okay. But right now we're gonna check Timburr. Will you please tap that button? Let's see what we got. Timburr! It's kind of funny how he's holding a log of wood, right?
That's okay. Kind of a bad thing, but yes.
Kind of weird. He's definitely an odd Pokemon. But like when you think about Pokemon like Magnemite and Klink, like it just, it make, whatever. There's Pokemon of all kinds. One shake, two shakes, three shakes, yeah.
Good to go, right on. Awesome.
Good, caught yours too, right?
Yes, yes,
yes.
I did.
Yes, very nice.
I don't know what he was.
Very cool. Okay, oh, his is good too, 722.
So, we're rocking. But
very nice.
It's this is a pleasure, it really is. I do appreciate it, and you rock, and I will definitely follow you along.
Wow, so thank
keep
you so
up
much.
With her, she's awesome. Thank
wow.
you very much. You guys are awesome.
Thank
I appreciate
you very
it.
Much. Well, fist bump. Boom.
Have a very good day. Be safe out there.
Thank you. Good
you
luck
guys
on
be
Giovanni.
Safe. Thank you very much. Bye, guys. Be safe.
Bye. And now we have some eggs hatching. I think just two eggs to be exact. But this is going to go ahead and conclude the video today, guys. I had a fantastic time walking around Sunset Park. I was really upset earlier today. I was just basically getting ready to explode today. I was going to make a video telling you how I felt about this, that, and the other thing, all related to the game. Everything is related to the game. All my frustrations are related to the game. And I was going to make a video about that, but after walking around today, just being in the sunshine, getting some vitamin D, getting some exercise, petting some dogs, talking to some nice people, and you know, smiling with them, I just have to say that that has made everything so much better. I mean, those issues are still there, but now I realize that like your day-to-day life, you can only control so many things. So I'm just gonna continue to do whatever makes me happy. I think that at this time in my life, voicing all my opinions about stuff would have the possibility of making things more negative. So I am going to refrain from saying my thoughts towards things right now that could be controversial, but probably later on in the future, if I ever stop playing Pokemon Go, I'm gonna make a video about how I really feel about everything. But until that time, guys, all I can say is you're in control of your own happiness. Just do things that make you happy. Go outside, talk to people, pet your cat, pet your dog, hug your friends. Remember that humanity is all we've got. So hold things tightly, cherish each other. I'm getting like emotional, but I love you guys. I'm so happy that I have this platform. I'm glad that I can talk to you guys. Remember to smash that like button. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.